Okay, Don Maximiano, he founded the winery around 150 years ago. It was in 1870. Before that, when he was only 25 to 30 years old, he was already a person that was very well known in Chile. Don Maximiano first started to study and then he founded the first gas company of Chile, giving light to the city. He also founded the copper company, which he had 33% of the total copper of Chile. After that, he also became a politician and he ended up being the ambassador of Chile in UK. Right after that, he decided to forget about all that and just focus in something new where he can enjoy his life. That's why he moved to Aconcagua Valley, 150 kilometers north, where he founded Viña Racis. At that time, nothing was in there. He has to build everything from zero, from the apartments to the workers to the vineyards. The winery started to develop step by step, and in the meantime, also, the Racis family became even more famous. We have in Chile four presidents of the country that are part of the Racis family, also two archbishops. And together with that, we go year by year until nowadays, when we are with the fifth generation and Eduardo Chadwick is in charge of the winery right now. He has been very important for the winery because he took the concept from Europe to become a very premium and iconic winery. He went to study to France, he was studying in Bordeaux, and within all the people that he met, Emily Penot is one of those who teach him how to become or how to provide to the land better quality standards. We've been one of the pioneers producing in Hillside thanks to Eduardo Chadwick. Eduardo Chadwick also brought to Chile Syrah. And with all that, Errázuriz year by year and working hard in every country, we have managed to become one of the most iconic wineries in the country. To make a long story short, in Chile, it was the Spaniards who brought the wine culture to the country. But when they left, at that time, only the wine was produced around Santiago, the capital of Chile. Then some wineries started to explore new lands. And in the case of Don Maximiano Errázuriz, he decided to go up north and he went to Aconcagua Valley. It was an area that it was not a wine region, but he could see at that time the possibilities and the potential of that land to produce high quality wines. That's why we went to Aconcagua Valley. What is the difference of Aconcagua Valley within other valleys? Aconcagua, in that region up in the north, is getting the water from the highest mountain from the Andes. And at the same time, when we go to the coast, only 12 kilometers far, we get our Aconcagua Costa vineyards. That part of the region is very important for us, because the climate is very cool. It's a cool climate that goes closer to south of France, for example. And there we can produce wines that are gonna be more focused in the elegance, in the minerality, and are gonna have a very nice acidity that is gonna bring from Chile wines that are gonna be more focused on the elegance and more quality wines. From the other side, we get the rest of the land where we are producing in the valley, within the both mountains, where we are producing the rest of wines. The most Bordeaux style wines as could be Carmenere or could be the Cabernet Sauvignon, for example. There we get a Mediterranean climate. That Mediterranean climate gives us high temperature during the day, but a low temperature during the night, letting the grapes rest and give their best qualities and potential. Berlin tasting, Eduardo Chadwick is a person that when he has something in his mind, he wants to go for it. Berlin tasting was the way to be able to show to the world that Chile is producing high quality wines. What happened is, like, as you may know, in Napa Valley, they did the Judgment of Paris, and they did a blind tasting for the best Napa Valley wines against the top wines from France. That placed Napa Valley as a main region nowadays as a high quality wines producer. So Eduardo Chadwick wanted to do something similar, and we did in Berlin. The idea was to introduce our wines, as was Don Maximiano that we have here, together with Seña and Viñedo Chadwick, to be against the top wines from France and Italy. And we choose the best vintage of the time, the Millennium Vintage. It was the 2000 vintage, where Sassicaia, Tignanello, Chateau Latour, Chateau Margaux, Lafite, all those wines got 100 points. So he wanted to show that we were able to be at the same level of those wines. As a result, two of our top wines, Chadwick and Seña, remain in the first position. And also Don Maximiano stay in the top 10. That made that all the wine critics realized that Chile was able to produce high quality wines. And we have also one extra advantage. We are coming from the new world. And to get that high quality wine, we are able to provide also a price that is much more reasonable. After Berlin, we saw that it was a very good result for us. So we thought that it would be good to repeat in other countries, because in the end, each country has a different taste in terms of food and in terms of drinks.
From Berlin, this unique experience was recreated in the wine capitals of the world, setting out to test the ultimate standards of quality for an icon wine, consistency, and aging potential. Yet in Sao Paulo, Tokyo, Beijing, London, New York, Hong Kong.
Within those countries, we get Korea. Korea, Don Maximiano has been awarded as the best wine. Same as China, for example, same as Netherlands, same as Sweden, and also same as Chile. I mean, our own country chose Don Maximiano over the rest of wines. Añonaseyo, Errazuriz, Santiago Díaz, Ibnida, Errazuriz Maní, Saranje Chiseyo. Thank you.